Welcome back to Fallout 4. So I sit here inside of my little house I made myself. We got McCready at the table, and he's not shutting up. But what's got me worried and kind of terrified is we have Nick over there cooking something on the stove. Nick is a synth. He doesn't eat. Why is he butchering small animals? Yeah, you walk away. Anyway, welcome back. Kate has been trying to get my attention for a little bit. I don't know if she actually has anything important to say or not, but let's find out. I think I got the message. McCready, shut up. I think Kate might have hit one too many cabins. She's trying to walk through a wall. Okay, we'll come to you.
Hey.
This better be worth it. You have time to talk now. Still have something important to say.
Go on.
I'm not sure how to put this. We've been on the road together for a while. And we've taken some hard knocks. But through all that crap, I notice you've always been sticking by me. You know, watching me back and making sure I don't do anything stupid. I think maybe it's time to tell you a little bit about who you're traveling with. There's no reason for us to keep acting like we're strangers.
Didn't we already go through this? You don't owe me a thing.
It all starts with two wastes of humanity. I suppose you could call me parents.
Oh boy.
I'm convinced I was a mistake, because I can't remember a single moment that they treated me like their daughter. I was yelled at and beaten. Everything I did was wrong. Nothing but a nuisance in their eyes. The whole time I was telling myself that they had to love me, even if it was just the tiniest bit, because they never kicked me out. Then me 18th birthday arrived, and I found out why they kept me around.
She was an investment to be sold.
They strapped a shock collar around me neck and sold me to slavers. They didn't even care enough about me to say goodbye.
Yeah, that's messed up.
18 years of suffering through that shite, and all I was worth to them was a pocket full of caps.
My God, I'm so sorry.
Thanks. But there is more to the story. It would be easy to blame me charming personality on me parents. But they didn't make me this way. I did.
Did she kill her parents?
I was with those slavers for 5 years. Roughest five of me goddamn life. The things they made me do. The way they use me for their amusement. It sickens me to me stomach even thinking about it. But I bided me time and learned to use their own methods against them. Stealing a few caps out of a sleeping man's pocket is a piece of cake. As long as you don't get greedy.
I imagine she killed them.
I can't believe you tolerated that. I would have killed them all.
That's easy for you to say. You weren't there. You have no idea what I went through. It took every ounce of patience I had. But after 5 years, I had finally pocketed enough to buy my own way out of there. But instead of heading off to try and repair the shambles of me life, I gave in to me rage and I headed home. You can imagine the look on me parents' faces when I kicked open their door. What you can't imagine is what they looked like after. After I emptied me gun into them.
I don't know what to say here, because no matter what she did was wrong, but what they did was terrible and incomprehensible too, so. Either way, it was murder.
That's murder.
Was it murder? Or was it justice? When I close my eyes, all I can see is their faces twisted with fear. And then my mind starts wandering and I start judging myself. And it's ripping me the fuck apart. You think I inject myself with all that shite and drink myself drunk because I'm a tough Irish girl? I do it so I can forget and move on with my miserable life. So there you are. The entire flawed package known as Kate. Stripped bare for your perusal.
Don't worry. I haven't lost faith in you.
I knew I was taking a chance telling you all this. I'm just glad I haven't disappointed you.
It's fine.
Good. I wouldn't want to strain our little partnership. Well, thanks for listening to me prattle. I suppose we can get back to business now.
That's That's nasty business.
Man, they could really use a cigarette.
Can't say that they probably didn't deserve it, but that's nasty business. Alright, so now that we have that out of the way, I think I actually want to do a few quests today. We've been doing a lot of exploring and stuff. Exploration is fine. I mean, it's a nice thing to do, but questing is where it's at. Let's go ahead and crack open the list here. I don't have anything... wrong tab. I don't have anything new yet, so I still just have the same quest right here. So I think what we're going to do is go ahead and head back to the Institute and I think reject his offer. I don't know why I marked that. I have to teleport no matter what. The Institute. Yes. And of course it will just be me going into the Institute by my lonesome. Nobody will be joining me. If I saw that bug in real life, I think I would probably soil myself.
I hear we're about to get a new food supplement.
That's lovely. I don't care.
Coursers give me the creeps, you know? They seem, I don't know, cold.
Greetings. As the Institute's requisition vendor, I can provide supplies for your missions on the surface. How may I assist you today?
What can I requisition?
I have access to a modest selection of arms, armor, and other items approved for use in field missions.
I just got distracted.
Let's see what you have.
So, now, answer me this. Why would, wow. That's a heck of a plasma weapon. You know, if I don't get that now, I don't think I can ever get it. Because eventually I'm not going to be able to, come back here. It's increased energy damage resistance, lower health. That's pretty neat. Not really seeing anything here I really, really want. So what I think I'm going to go ahead and do is just buy plasma cartridges. Because I need more ammo always. And if I have any purified water left, I don't think I do. But if I have any purified water, we'll dump that. Yeah, no, it's gone. I have used it all. The stim packs. Yeah, we'll do the stim packs too. Alright, speaking of plasma, this thing I'm using right here is that irradiated plasma thrower that I had before. I've modified it now that it is currently set up as a plasma pistol, but it has the fiery thing, so it sets people on fire. It does a lot of radiation damage as well as the energy and physical damage a plasma weapon normally does. This thing should be pretty beastly. Hello, quote-unquote Sean. Is there anything in here I can steal before we get down to the nitty-gritty? Is that supposed to be like a power port or something? I have no idea. So much paper, so much plastic. Preserved cigarette pack. Bourbon, clean coffee cup. They have a lot of cameras and coffee cups in the Institute. I just realized that.
Now that you've had a chance to see the Institute firsthand, what do you think?
I'm, not going to stay with you, Braytek.
First things first. How do I get back to the surface?
The same way you got in, of course. You are not a prisoner here. You may come and go as you please. Ultimately, all our knowledge and resources are focused on a single goal. The goal is best summarized by our motto. Mankind. Redefined. Unfortunately, no advancement comes without occasional setbacks. As remarkable as our synths are, they can be... dangerous without proper supervision.
It's not the sense that are dangerous.
Mind and body attempting to wrestle with something approaching free will can be a recipe for chaos.
If the synths are intelligent and self-aware, then they have a right to free will.
However closely they may approximate human behavior, they are still our creations. When you see what I have to show you, I think you'll agree that we know what is best for our synths. A rogue synth has taken over the raider gang at Libertalia. His memories have been erased, and his identity altered. He believes he's a man named Gabriel. Under his leadership, the raiders have taken many innocent lives. I've dispatched a courser to Libertalia. I'd like you to join him and reclaim that synth.
Who erased his memories? And why?
Those idealistic radicals who call themselves the Railroad are behind it. We'll deal with them in time. But right now, the priority is to reclaim that synth before more harm is done. Now you should get moving. Many people are in danger, and a delay could cost lives.
I don't want to actually help this guy. Do I have to do this for the quest? Have I gone too far?
God is more than just our leader. He is our creator.
That's some freakish... So where are we going? All the way over here. I've already been here. Okay. Let's go to the wharf. Oh yeah, it's a wharf. You know what? I don't think I've actually been here. I think I might have been thinking of another wharf. It's pretty neat looking though. Let's see. Our marker is over this way, and if you notice any difference in sound, I moved my microphone a little closer. I didn't realize I'd push it so far away.
I'm ready to move in, sir.
I'm sure you are.
I think we're being shadowed.
I think it's... Yeah, it's a vertebrate from the Brotherhood. They're just going to cause trouble.
No, you don't.
No, don't attack the vertebrate.
I was hoping for a challenge. Guess I'll keep hoping.
Yeah, well, whatever. So the guy we're looking for is down the wharf area down here, right? We're going to go ahead and go on without the courser. The reason for this is, if possible, I would like to try to talk to this guy, and I don't think the courser would let me do that. In the water. And he just died. Oh no, he's swimming. So who died? Oh God. Oh God. Mistakes have been made. Mistakes have been made. I'm hearing so many missiles in the background. Oh, God. Critical time. Enough to get rid of you. We got some paladins here. That's awesome. as long as they come this way before the courser does. Oh, nope. They're killing X6. Alright, let's rob these guys blind and keep going. Alright, so our goal is to get to that boat over there, I believe. There's the vertebrate. That guy keeps getting headshots on me.
This has to be a joke.
Alright. Let's flank. Oh! There's a medicine thing in here. Sweet. Now, I have a feeling that Kate would really, truly appreciate a minigun.
Come on, you stupid bastards. Come on.
Yeah, I'm not hitting that. Turret, turret, turret. Kate, you're killing me. Please do not get up behind me like that, okay? So I think we lost the courser. Really, actually, it's pretty, stuff. Not impressed, but not Rob. So it's in here, right? This is a nice little boat. Where are you?
Ain't personal, just you or me.
Oh!
This is gonna be a piece of cake!
That was a Molotov to the face. That was a Molotov to the face. There we are. Cripple your head. Oh, man, not again. All right, the good news is good news is we're making progress. Wow, she had a lot of grenades. They're really throwing Molotovs onto the only platform away from where they are right now, and it's made out of wood. Really? We're getting a really bad rad storm coming through, too. Thank you. is like the worst weather for this. Okay, that turret's gone. Where is he? Oh, there he is. All right. Oh, this is just getting creepy. Keep an eye out for any more of the med kits and stuff, because I am going to be going through a ton of stim packs here. Actually, I'll tell you what, let's go ahead and pop a rad away and a rad X. Aid. Okay, so I'll get a little bit less radiation overall, plus it'll heal up higher. Don't know if this random radiation damage applies to the enemies, too. Be good to know, actually. Oh, well, there's a crashed vertebrate, and here's a pile of dead bodies. Trader outfits, canned dog food. You know, it's kind of hard to find a large amount of clothing items. So while I feel kind of bad about this, oh, never mind. Thought there was another body, just a leg. Looks like these two died of the exact same kind of wounds, but they died next to each other. Guess who's going to be carrying some stuff, Kate?
Yo, psst.
How much do these weigh, anyway? Huh, I didn't know undershirt and jeans gave you a luck bonus. Can't carry anymore. What do you mean you can't carry anymore? Tell you what, drop the baseball bat, okay? I actually can't make her drop it. Shotgun shell, take. Oh, you still have a ton of freaking purified water. Hmm, unfortunate. Okay. Let's get out of here. We're just gonna store these here temporarily. We'll come back from it at a later point. Not junk. There we go. Alright, so we'll come back for that later. Okay, it looks like the storm's clearing up, so we missed most of that. Go on, Kate.
Psst. Yeah?
On him.
Will do.
Go! Oh, you...
Okay, that was some bullshit.
No, that was all you.
Oh, that must have hurt.
That was all you. Alright, so it looks like we take a, looks like a suspension thing here. Yeah, check it out. We'll take a ride over. There's a Raider waster over there.
Everything's starting to sound like footsteps these days.
Hey, guys!
Are you fucking kidding me?
Hey guys. Ooh, 10mm ammo. I need more 10mm ammo, please. I mean, I feel a little bad about this. Not enough to stop, but just a little bad. Alarm clock. For the record, yes, I did hear them coming. I've got, like, the feeling that whatever this is, it's not going to be exactly what Father told us.
Playing games with me, huh?
Yes, in fact, yes, I am.
Only a fucking coward hides.
Language, really? Yeah, okay, there's a way up here. Really? Taunting the person with the pistol. Oh, that has no ammo. she just used a stim pack. That's cheating. That is cheating. Come on, get revolver to the face.
You gotta reload sometime, asshole.
I just did, you. Fat man. Oh, jeez. I'm glad they attacked melee, because that would have been bad. Like, really, really bad. This place is not so great for my frame rate, it looks like, but we'll be out of here pretty soon. I'm gonna get all the way up here, right, and find out that the NPC I'm looking for does not spawn unless you have the cursor with you. I just feel it. Oh, it's a door.
Hold up a moment, sir. There's something important I need to tell you.
What is it?
I'm going to give you B-592's reset code. If he hears the code phrase, it'll reset his cognitive processes and make him docile. You'll need to say, B-592, initialize factory reset, followed by the authorization code, Gamma-71-Epsilon. Once he's shut down, I can transport him safely back to the Institute.
Good. I'd like to avoid any unnecessary violence.
I don't know. I was kinda hoping for a fight.
Well, he might not be alone up there. Violence might be inevitable. That's all, sir. Ready when you are.
I'm kinda disappointed he teleported to me. Though I suppose he had to tell me that, but still. What are you?
Bingo.
Plus 25% damage and limb damage, but has more recoil. That's a pretty weird shotgun. We'll take it. We'll take it. Toolcase, duct tape. Dirty water life preserver. This just goes up. Footlighter, Gabriel's terminal. I think we want to get a little information before we go up. Run, update user Gabriel, complete previous user files archived, delete all files, delete all files. Nope, how to delete old files, how to fix piece of shit terminal. Command help unknown. All right, so it's pretty good, about a year. May 2282, so here we are, our new home. Only casualty was one of Anderson's less useful toes. Otherwise, I'd say cleaning the Myrlurks out of these old husks went pretty well. Now we just have to figure out what to do next. Been a long time since any of us knew life outside the Minutemen. But General Becker was the only thing holding those folks together. Now that he's dead, it's just a matter of time until the militias start turning on each other. Not worth sticking around for that. But we can make something of this place. I know it. November 2282. We're running through food a lot faster than we planned. People are starting to get hungry. We're rationing, but the scouts need to turn up something or something soon, or we're in trouble. I had Anderson and Williams hang today. Not pleased about executing the best guns we still had, but it needed to be done. End of last month, they started finding big caches of food and supplies. We were starving, so I didn't ask where it came from. Then today, we get a visit from the Bunker Hill guards. Turns out my boys have been hitting the caravans, feeding us the spoils. I gave the guards my word those boys would see justice, and I kept my word. But justice doesn't put food in my people's mouths. No FMR, another caravan stifled my boys. This mercenary stuff we've been driven into isn't worth it when the bastards don't pay. I tried to get the merchants at Bunker Hill to cut us some slack to give us something, anything to eat, but they wouldn't deal. They're in on it too, I guarantee. No, this ends now. Today, me and my boys will make an example. That would be the pile of bodies, maybe. Four new recruits today said they heard about all the caps the raiders in the bay had been pulling in. Raiders. That's what they call us, and they're not wrong. We're making money hand over fist. Bunker Hill, the caravans. They pay us to do nothing, to leave them alone. This is the best shape we've been in since leaving the Minutemen. General Becker would be sick if he saw us now, but he's dead and we're alive. I don't feel like writing anymore. So he turned to banditry only because he got effed over.
Let's see what we've got.
Doesn't necessarily sound enthralled with being a bandit, though.
Nice.
Oh. I can't move. Oh, I'm one over. Just eat a bunch of flowers.
Crap, crap, nothing.
I'm
but
ready
crap.
To move in, sir.
All right, up we go. Oh, before we do that, I suppose I should equip a weapon. Eddie's piece is not that bad.
Well done.
By your gear, I'm going to guess you two are agents of the Institute.
Just like me.
So,
you
made it to the top. Is the Institute so desperate for resources that it's stealing plunder from honest, hard-working Commonwealth gangs?
How much plunder have you got?
So you are here for loot, then.
What are you doing, boss? We can take these guys.
Keep your mouth shut! I know what I'm doing!
We got a modest little stash. I'll tell you what. I'll give it to you, freely, if you walk away afterwards. What do you say? Do I have your word?
And if I refuse?
Take the goods. Why fight for it if we can just walk away?
That's the way you want it? Then let's finish this!
You've got 592. Yep. Initialized factory reset. Authorization Gamma 71 Epsilon.
I'm going to die. Oh, the reload time on this is terrible.
It's called shooting straight.
Sloppy tactics, bad aim. This won't take long.
Did you see that?
Looks like he got reset no matter what. Where'd he go?
Disappearing act, huh?
Dying time is here.
Secured. Nice work, sir. I'll take the synth back. This is X688. Ready to relay with reclaimed synth B592.
I don't like that.
Ammo, caps, whatever you find, don't forget to share.
I don't like what this ended with. No, I don't like that. Safe requires terminal. I guess this would be the stash.
Nice.
All right, let's get back to the Institute.
Feels like this project has been going on for months.
I think I might have gone too far in with the Institute. I hope that's not the case.
I'm glad to see you return safely. I know the task was difficult, but I needed you to see firsthand how dangerous a rogue synth can be.
The Institute created that synth, so the Institute is responsible for what it does.
I disagree. A synth is no more inherently evil than a handgun. When a man dies by gunshot, is the weapon's maker blamed? Of course not. The blame rightly falls on he who pulled the trigger. Yes, we created the synth. But whether they intended to or not, the railroad's agents turned it into a killer. But enough about that. The task is done. And you've returned our synth safely to us. I couldn't have hoped for a better outcome. Well done. While you were away, I had quarters prepared for you. You'll find all the basic necessities, as well as a generous stock of arms and equipment. Go and have a look. I think you'll be quite pleased.
Son.
Libertalia isn't hard to find. Just look for the jumble of wrecked ships floating in the harbor.
It's kind of weird just calling him son.
The sooner that synth is safely back in the Institute,
okay, I have to complete it
for everyone.
Downstairs.
Bet it's pretty boring down here compared to up there.
Your new quarters are here, sir.
Thanks, you.
Ooh, preserve cigarette pack.
When you're finished here, sir, Father wants to see you.
Oh.
Safety first. Remember that.
Status. All functions normal.
I don't suppose I can, like, talk you out of this, right?
It's my responsibility to make sure this place runs smoothly.
I would like to point out that that is a terrible name for the quest. It tells you what's going to happen.
Sean.
Hello, Father. Tell me, what would you do when someone has stolen from you?
I try and talk it out, see if things can be resolved peacefully.
An admirable goal. And yet we find ourselves in a situation where something more significant must be done. The group that calls themselves the Railroad have acquired several synths from the Institute. Synths that had gone missing in recent months. They no doubt mean to free these synths, in their delusion that synths are somehow sentient beings.
They are.
You've been in contact with the railroad, so you're aware of their misguided beliefs.
They mean well. They're only doing what they think is right.
You dealt with Libertalia. That's the result of their selfish, short-sighted plan. Usually they are a minor nuisance, but lately they have become more emboldened. I'm afraid we've reached the point where a response is necessary. We have learned the current location of these synths, and need to reacquire them before the railroad can hide them.
That sounds way too dangerous.
It shouldn't be, but it's important that we act on this soon, before the railroad has any indication we've tracked them. We also don't want the Brotherhood of Steel getting wind of the presence of the synths. That would only complicate matters.
Is it just me, or will I have backup?
Of course, sir. We'll be waiting for you outside Bunker Hill. You'll have support should you need it. But we want to keep this small.
No, I don't want to do this. F this place. Where's the railroad at? They're, Finale Hall of Constitution. Where's that church? On North Church. Can we tattletale? See if we can actually talk to the railroad and tell them. Because it went out of the way specifically to mention that they don't want the Brotherhood or the railroad to know. So this should be the railroad should be in here in the basement. Still a dead body, right? Okay.
Let me know if you find some spare ammo.
I have, I'm keeping it. Oh, this is a really nasty little place. Well, they're not hostile yet.
Hope you didn't mind the reception. When you tango with the Institute, you gotta be careful when someone new gets on the dance floor.
Your leader was just being cautious.
Exactly. Kind of killed our chance at a friendly first impression, though. But it's all good now. I vouched for you, nobody got shot. Still, I would consider it a close personal favor if you didn't sell us out to the Institute. Thanks.
So tell me, why did you vouch for me?
In our little outfit, it's my job to know things. And with everything you've done, it's clear you're capable. A dangerous enemy. And I'm betting, a valuable ally.
But why the trust? You can't be taking it all on faith.
I don't know if we can trust you, but I hope we can. We just survived a hell of a crisis, so we may just be a teeny-weeny bit desperate for new members. If everything was sunshine and bottle caps, we'd probably play a longer getting-to-know-you game. But we don't have that luxury.
I'm gonna press my luck.
Really? Is that all?
You just don't give up. Alright, I have a short list of people I think would be a good fit for our family. You piqued my interest, so Maybe I asked around. Did my homework. If you hadn't found us, there's a chance I would have found you instead. Thanks for saving me the trip. So Dez wants me to make you a tourist. That's what we call someone who helps out with the odd job here and there. What a waste. I'm just gonna come out and say this. The railroad needs you.
You got my attention.
I got a job. Too big for me, just perfect for the two of us. You help me out, we turn a few heads, and then Dez invites you into the fold. Then, if you get into a bind and need some help, your buddies in the railroad got your back.
What's the job?
So, up front, the only thing I'll say is that it's gonna be a wild and dangerous ride, but probably nothing new for someone like you.
Yeah, why not?
Sign me up, then.
Perfecto! Let's meet up at the old freeway outside of Lexington. I'll fill you in once you get there.
Alright, so can I, like, talk to you?
You know, if you need our help, you only have to ask.
Desdemona.
We'll file out separately after you leave. Best not to attract attention here. Come here again if you need to meet us. We'll know you're coming.
I'm trying
You've
to...
You've been busy. Oh. You know, if you need our help, you only have to ask.
You're a terrible person. Why don't you let me talk?